As much as Motorsport 7 is a spectacular game with an insane car list, and also sounding cars, there are also some bad aspects in the game. So here are 5 things I hate about Forza Motorsport 7, enjoy the video. Number 1, the glitches. This may possibly be the most broken game out there. Seriously, I've never played a game this broken since Test Drive Unlimited 2. So some of the glitches may be funny, as shown by my good friend Shinyod.
Oh!
But the glitches can also get fucking annoying, again shown by Shinyod.
Forza, you've done a good job. Oh, it's the game broke. It's just a black screen.
Oh, and here's another example from AR12 Gaming.
Different.
Soon. Did anyone see that Camaro legit drop out of the sky?
As you can tell, the game is very glitchy and weird, so fingers crossed they'd patch these glitches, as it's a pain in the ass. Number 2, game crashing. All games crash sometimes, it's a fact. However, Motorsport 7 is on a whole other level when it comes to crashing. When you're upgrading your car, crash. When you're on a loading screen, crash. And when you spend hours in a design which I absolutely love and cherish, guess what? Crash. This is by far the most annoying problem in Motorsport 7, and this needs to be addressed immediately. Number 3, the full airfield test track. In previous Motorsport games like 5, 6, and even 7, they had the airfield test track, which I'm sure we've all driven on. The Motorsport 5 and 6 have a full airfield, which is an open space where you can practice drifting or just mess about. This is probably my favourite feature on any Motorsport game, as it's really useful and a handy feature. So where is it in Motorsport 7 then? It's gone. Yep, that's right, gone. Thanks to this, it's hard learning to drift. All we can hope for is that they include a full airfield in a future update. Number 4, overpriced cars. In Forza Motorsport 6, the R34 cost 57,000 credits. Horizon 3, 63,000, so you'd expect Motorsport 7 to be around 70,000 or 80,000, right? Well, guess what? It isn't. It is in fact what you'd call 210,000 credits. Some may argue that it's easy to earn money in the game, which it is, but come on, 200 grand for an R34? No thanks. Number 5, Toyota. Okay, I know this isn't Toyota's fault, so I'm not blaming them for this, but Toyota is probably one of the most popular JDM car manufacturers out there. They produced awesome cars like the GT86, Celica, AE86, and the Supra. I was once so excited to build a drag Supra in the game, and that's when I realised there were no Toyotas in the game. You can probably imagine my reaction at that moment. So if for some reason Toyota want to get back into racing games, that would be awesome. I'd love to hear that legendary 2JZ in Motorsport 7. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I did miss out 2 things which I also hated about Motorsport 7, which is the shopping basket and the really, really slow loading speeds. But anyways, please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, as it really does help a lot. And if I get 50,000 subscribers by June 2018, I will do a giveaway of my Thrustmaster 458 Spider racing wheel. So subscribe. Until next time, guys. Peace out.